and looking up, and it's total. It was astonishing. I've never not been interested in astronomy. What's special about the August 21st eclipse of 2017 is that it cuts directly across the United States. The moon will pass exactly in front of the sun and cover it entirely. This is a total eclipse of the sun. It's a remarkable track in the sense of just how many people are close to the eclipse track this time. If you're in a path of totality, there's another effect that happens. It has to be very close to total, but in the minute or so before totality, what can happen is you start seeing dancing shadows, which are due to the fact that the atmosphere is acting sort of like the surface of a swimming pool. If you look at the bottom of a swimming pool, you can see the waves being projected on the bottom of a strange illumination pattern. And something very similar to that happens in an eclipse. And it occurs because all of the light of the sun is now coming from a tiny spot on the sun instead of from the whole disk. During an eclipse, which isn't total, there still are things you can see. One thing is that the light looks strange, especially the more of the sun is covered, the stranger it looks, because it looks dim. Another thing, which is a little more subtle, is that if you look at the shadows of trees, under a tree, you'll see little circles of light, which are projected images of the sun, which come and go as the leaves rustle. But in a partial eclipse, those circles turn into little crescents, which is an amazing thing to see. There is something deeply, deeply strange and utterly unsettling in a way that's visceral and can't be put into words. It has to be experienced. Of having the sky and the world go dark in the middle of the day. This should be on your bucket list. It is an experience. It's one of the great spectacles of nature. It's a rare experience, and it's just one of the things I think that everybody should see if they possibly have the opportunity to see it.